Welcome to the Amphenol Broadband Solutions training on the Times Fiber Communications Series 11 QC2 Connector. In this training, we'll provide a Series 11 connector overview, explain the Series 11 connector features and benefits, look at the prep tools required for cable preparation and connector installation, show how to prepare the cable, and show how to install the Series 11 connector. The QC2 Series 11 connector is a universal compression connector that's ideally suited for professional and consumer use. Its one-piece design provides a secure 360-degree compression seal for maximum RF shielding performance. The all-metal design of the connector body and nut allow for excellent electrical and mechanical performance. And it has an advanced pre-positioned polymer compression system to ensure a consistent fit with the cable. Its one-piece all-metal design provides shielding up to minus 120 dB at cable TV frequencies. The connector is universal and works on standard, tri-shield, and quad-shield cables. Now we'll look at the connector mechanics. The movable pin design makes center conductor installation easy and ensures proper center conductor seating. The connector has an externally mounted continuous ground member, which eliminates costly service calls due to issues such as digital tiling and pixelation, which are typically caused by loose connectors. It also prevents signal ingress and egress by maintaining a ground plane between the main body and nut with post, even when the connector is in a loosened state. This doesn't mean that you don't have to tighten connectors. Always follow your company procedures for tightening connectors. It has three internal weather seals, creating and maintaining an airtight seal. The first weather seal we'll look at is between the main body and the nut with posts. This maintains and seals even when the continuous ground feature is engaged. Next is the weather seal on the compression ring. This maintains an airtight seal once the sleeve is compressed. The nut weather seal maintains an airtight seal once the connector is tightened to the F port. Next, we'll look at the tools needed for cable preparation and connector installation. The Times Fiber Connector Installation Toolkit has most of the tools you'll need: nitrile rubber gloves, compression tool, cable prep tool, and cable cutters. You also need a 7/16-inch wrench, preferably a preset torque wrench, and a braid brush is useful. Now we're ready to prep the cable. Using the cutting tool provided by Times Fiber Communications or a diagonal pliers, cut the end of the cable squarely and cleanly. Place the cable with the end cut straight into the prep tool until the cable hits the cable stop. This will ensure a 5/16 inch for the center conductor and a 1/4 inch for the foil and the braid. If the cable end is angled, you won't get a proper 5/16 inch length for the center conductor. So never break off the cable stop or the center conductor may be the wrong length. Rotate the prep tool about 4 times until you feel and hear it stop cutting. Pinch the end of the prep tool and pull it straight off the end of the cable. Inspect the cable, ensuring there's no pieces of braid or foil touching the center conductor. Long braids or braids wrapped around the center conductor indicate dull blades. With a bristle brush, Brush the braid evenly over the jacket. Don't use your bare hands as the oils and salts that are on your skin will get on the braid and foil and could cause them to corrode. This can also be accomplished using the gloves provided in the Times Fiber Communications Toolkit. Inspect the braid foldback, ensuring that it's even around the cable. By using the proper prep tool and folding the braid back properly, the center conductor will be 5/16 of an inch with a tolerance of plus or minus 1/32 of an inch. The exposed foil will be 1/4 inch and the braid will be folded back uniformly around the cable jacket. If using tri or quad shield cables, completely remove the outer layer of foil before brushing back the braid evenly around the cable. To install a connector, align the connector with the prepped cable end and slide onto the cable, applying pressure until the movable pin dielectric is flush with the top of the connector post and the pin extends past the top of the connector. A gloved hand may offer a firmer grip if the cable is cold or when using underground or quad shield cables. For quad shield cables or other tough cables, it may make connector installation easier to separate the compression sleeve from the connector body. This may also make it easier to align the connector to the cable as it eliminates a blind entry. Now we're ready to compress the connector. Seat the connector and the cable into the compression tool and compress until the compression sleeve is fully compressed. Don't overcompress the connector or you could damage the compression sleeve. Next, attach the compressed connector to the F port and finger tighten. Using an approved torque wrench, slowly tighten the connector until the recommended torque is reached, ensuring that you don't over-tighten the connector. Let's review what we've covered in this training session on the QC2 Series 11 connector. I provided an overview of the Series 11 connector, showed the Series 11 connector features and benefits, such as the triple weather seals and continuous ground. We looked at the tools required for prepping and installing the connector. I showed the proper cable preparation steps and showed how to successfully install a Series 11 connector onto the cable. Thank you for viewing this training on the Times Fiber Communications Series 11 QC2 connector. For additional training topics, see our website at www.amphenolbroadband.com.